Shalom. Before I begin this video, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, and double honors to the apostles and elders of the great millstone that continually rule well. And Shalom to the hopeful elect that's also doing this work. Sincerity. Or should I say sincerely, Salakia. In all faith, truth, and giving all diligence. Now, the topic of this video is going to be entitled Flow Like Water, in which this topic is basically is going to be going into a brief, or should I say, just going to go into the spirit, in which is likened unto water. All right, in which you know, it's pretty much going to be a brief lesson, brief video. Not going to take too much time to do this, but the thing about waters or the spirit, you know, we operate in the spirit of Yahweh, which is the name of the Heavenly Father, and is in the name of His Son, in which the Son's name is Yahweh Shai. So we operate in the spirit of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. And the spirit that we're working with is all water. And it's like a river. Alright? In which, if you know anything about you know, rivers, you know, it constantly flows. You know? It's always flowing. And that's how this truth is. The spirit continually flows. All right, we'll be on one topic, and we might move to another topic, and you know, wherever the spirit leads us, you know, that's where we go. All right, you know, I know where it says in the scripture where it speaks about the wind. You know, you can't tell which way the wind is blowing. All right, and that's how the spirit is. You'll never know where the spirit will take you. Okay. But see, there's a difference between our spirit, the spirit that we're working with, should I say, and the spirit that these other Israelite camps are working with. The spirit that they're working with is on the left-hand side, in which those are stagnant waters. All right? And when you go into the thing about stagnant waters, it doesn't flow. All right? It's like a dam that's put in a place where the river is supposed to flow. All right, and that's what they've done. They pretty much set up spiritually. They set up a dam to where the waters can't flow. All right, and we already know why they put that dam there, because they pretty much paid off. You know, Esau's giving them a paycheck. All right, and you know, in spiritual too, that you know, it's called a dam because, you know, the word dam, you know, I might be stretching a little far, but you know, that's like I said, man, it's all spiritual. But that word dam, if you add into it, you know, the word dam means to condemn. All right, and which that's what they've done, man. They condemned themselves. Okay. So you can clearly see that there's a difference between us and them. All right, because the spirit they're working with constantly flows. All right, and it's clean waters because it constantly flows. When you stop the flow of water, it doesn't flow. All right, it's not going to be able to. It's not clean waters, should I say? All right. It's not clean water. You know, the water is probably full of moss and, you know, frogs and, you know, insects and stuff like that, because it's not flowing. All right. Now, concerning this thing of ours, this faith, this truth, we go into every single topic that there is, man. We don't just dwell on, you know, telling our people their true nationality, and that's it. You know, we're giving them breakdowns, man. Give them edification. What we're doing in this faith is bringing out edification. This is for edification. Everything that we do is for edification. That's what the scriptures say. All right, let all things be done unto edification. All right, and that's exactly what we're doing. But those other guys, they're not edifying the congregation. All right, they're just teaching you how to, you know, keep your status in America, how to you know, keep your riches, you know, things that don't concern them, you know, concerns their salvation, man. All right. So, like I said before, man, the spirit that we're working with is the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. All right. So, man, with that, I'm going to go ahead and read this scripture, which is John chapter 7, verse 38. And it reads, "He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water." And see, that's the thing about this truth, man. You have to believe. All right, you have to believe that Yahweh Shai is going to return to deliver us. You have to believe that this place is going to be destroyed by thermonuclear fire. You have to believe that, I mean, even knowing that you're a Hebrew Israelite, man, that's belief in itself. All right. Just knowing that Esau is about to go into slavery, man, that's belief in itself, man. All right. And see, since these guys are doing these little shows that they got set up, which is no edification brought out on it, you know, just even to bug the congregation out even more. They pretty much, they're not working in the spirit of Yahweh Shai, man. Because when you take the name out of the equation, you know that a person is set up, man. Because there's so many scriptures that speak about the name of the Most High and the Son, man. So whenever you see a congregation take out the name, then that's a big problem, man. You know that camp is set up, man, by Esau. All right. And also too, man, when Yahweh Shai said, "Look, out of your belly is gonna flow rivers of living water," you know, that just goes to show you that it's gonna constantly flow. It's not gonna stop. All right. It's not gonna be held back. All right. That's why it's called living waters. It's actually those waters are alive, man. They're not dead, not like stagnant water. All right. And it's also refreshing to the soul, your spirit. All right. Whenever you think about you know, water, when it constantly flows, you know, that's refreshing. Even, you know, speaking from experience, you know, even seeing water, you know, flowing downstream, you know, that's even relaxing to the spirit. Just having, or should I say, even just seeing the sight of water flowing like that. You know, because, you know, water is very important, man. Even our own bodies are made out of mostly water. All right, that's why it's required that we take in a certain amount of water each day. All right, because our body needs that in order to continually function and to operate. And when you take that away, the body starts to shut down. And see, that's what these guys have done. They've taken the water away from the body, their body, right, their congregation, and now they're dying out, man. They're breaking down. Okay. So with that, man, I'm just going ahead and go ahead in the lesson. Hopefully you again were edified by this short video. And till next time, once again, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shai. double honors unto the apostles, and it was a great millstone that ruled very well. And peace and safety to the hopeful elect that's also pressing forward, man, pushing this gospel throughout the four corners of the earth in all faith, truth, and sincerity. And with that, I'm going to say shalom.